personally, with the coronavirus situation, I don't really find it safe to move out of the house, have an appointment scheduled for a laser session. Hi guys, welcome to a new video. I have been meaning to do this video for so long because one of the persons commented if it's worth paying the price for an at-home laser, and is it worth even spending that extra penny on customs charges. Personally, with the coronavirus situation, I don't really find it safe to move out of the house, have an appointment scheduled for a laser session. Laser sessions do cost quite a bit. If you're going to have your face done, it will cost you around 5,000. If you want to get underarms done, I think it's even more. And if you want a full body be done, it will take around 45,000 to 50,000. So it's just a single session. Imagine you having to do multiple sessions with this price range. I think with one session, you're paying just one session amount for a at-home laser device. And considering in the market now on social media sites, even they advertise cheap at-home laser devices. I'm not going to name those brands, but the question is, do these devices genuinely have a FDA approved, clinically proven and skin tested mark on their sales? I don't think so. These devices which I have spoken of earlier, like the Sensica SensiLite Pro Tria Beauty 4X laser and the Smooth Skin Bare Plus, all these devices are FDA approved, clinically proven and tested on the skin. So it's absolutely safe buying these devices. And considering the price point, like I have said earlier in the video, you are going to pay an amount for just a single session. You could get this device for that single session, and your hairs are not going to vanish with a single session. You will have to do multiple sessions, and it's going to depend upon your hair growth. So if you have like thick coarse hair, I think you will have multiple sessions from ranging from five to even six sessions, I believe. And with this device, I have been using this Sensica, especially. Sensica has like a wide window. I have done my legs like for 2 months since I have purchased this. It's been 2 months and I have hardly any hair growth. It has reduced to such an extent. There is just like patches here and there which I need to work on. Otherwise, you could see around 80% hair reduction I have seen on my legs with this device. It has a wide window, so it covers like a huge portion of the area. And once I have shown you in my earlier video, with 3 clicks it goes on automatic mode, so you don't have to constantly click this button. As far as Tria 4X laser, I have used that device exclusively only on my face, and I literally can see a change, 90% hair reduction. There's like little hairs here and there I can feel when I only rub my hand on my face. That's when I can feel only a few hairs here and there, but that has effectively worked. Considering the window is small, I have kept that device only for my face. I think that if you're going to use it for your whole body, it's going to be time consuming and you're going to exhaust the flashes. Since I have PCOS and I've been struggling with facial hair growth, I have kept that device particularly for my face. And this device and the Smooth Skin Bare, I alternate between them. These devices I use on my skin. The other question is, how do you prepare your skin and post care? So what you do is you shave the area clean. You can use a shaving, you said the Venus Satin shaving foam, shave the area clean, and you zap away the hairs. There's no need to put any soothing gel or anything. With these IPL and RPL devices especially, you don't have to use anything. Once you're done, you use either a seaweed gel or a aloe vera gel on your skin and you're good to go, or a thick moisturizer even, because it's going to dry out your skin, obviously, because these are using intense pulse light, so light will be flashed on your skin. It's going to even dry out the natural oils on your skin, so it's important that you use a good moisturizer once you're done with these devices. With the Tria Beauty, I have already spoken about this. Pain tolerance depends upon person to person. Since I have PCOS, I think my skin is delicate and sensitive, really sensitive, so I can feel the pain to the point that each hair that is electrocuted, people say it's a snap of a rubber band. So I feel each hair and the pain that is inflicted with it. So I don't use the device all by itself. I have to pre-prepare before I use the device. What I do is I use the Prelox cream, which is an anesthetic topical cream. You can use any anesthetic topical cream as far as it gives that anesthetic effect and there is an ease of using the Tria Beauty. It's fine by, you know, the whole process. Now, I personally use this to the Prelox cream, which I use is the instructions are such that you use the cream 1 hour prior session so the effect remains and you use the laser on your face. There is a slight redness when you use a laser. It is not just with at home laser, it's also with professional lasers. Mind you, Tria Beauty is using the professional technology in this at home laser. The diode laser is used in this at home device, which is at the palm of your hands. You can do it, you know, in the comfort of your own home. So once you're done with that, there will be slight redness. What you can do is take an ice cube, rub it all over so that you close down the pores. The pores will be open, obviously. Once you're done with that, I would recommend don't go straight away with a moisturizer. You use an aloe vera gel or a seaweed gel. Even I personally love seaweed gel. Aloe vera gel is also great, and it's great for things that do devices like this because you are inflicting some sort of heat on your skin. I think that should literally answer the question to if it's worth buying these devices. Now, you know, with the coronavirus situation, we are restricted from moving out of your homes, getting a scheduled appointment for the laser sessions. And like I've said, if the laser sessions are multiple and you want a professional to do it, you can do it at your own risk. I found this really a convenient thing. You don't have to go for your vaccine appointment even. You have everything at the comfort of your own home and you're using this device at your home. I know many people have lost their jobs because of the coronavirus and income is like really tight. But those who can afford these devices, I would give like a green signal. Please go ahead. If you have that amount of money, this literally made a hole in my pockets. Believe me, nobody has literally helped me in buying these devices. This was out of my own pockets, literally made a hole in my pockets, but it was absolutely worth it. And I kept thinking, is this purchase even worth it? I literally learned after a long run of use of these devices that they actually work. So, you know, why not? I have been doing waxing even at home. I have a wax heater. You can purchase wax, put in the wax heater and do your waxing sessions even at home. But I found that it is like a lot of mess, a lot of preparation. This is literally nothing. You just need a full charge. If it's a cordless device, you need a full charge. Smooth Skin Bear is a corded device. You have to plug it in, sit close by and just close to your plug point and just, you know, zap away the hairs. And this is what I have found much more convenient. I don't know about you. I have given all valid points why it is worth buying the device. So if you like what I have spoken about, you can hit the like button. And if you have any further queries, you can comment in the section below. And I will be more than happy to help. I don't think there's anything else that I can speak of about these devices. This is all that I have spoken of. Everything I have covered, I think, in this video, and you can check the earlier video even because this is the continuation to the earlier video. That's all for now. Until then, bye.